Hi. Today I'm going to show you how to make a flower pot cake. This is a cake for my daughter's kinder teacher. I just got confused with a different teacher who I thought was into gardening. Anyway, she's not into gardening, but it was a special birthday. So, it's a very simple cake to make. It looks really effective, but it's quite good. You don't actually need a really nice finished cake. You'll see my ganache job's really bad. I ended up using actually the batter that I usually use for my cupcake. So it's really soft. I had a bit of a disaster and dropped the cake. The original cake, which was a mud cake, which is what I always use. So it's a really soft cake. The ganache job is shocking. And there are bumps you can sort of see on the fondant, but it doesn't really matter. The whole overall picture looks really good. So I'm really happy with it. Anyway, hope you enjoy. Okay, so here is my first, that's my rough job of ganache, just because I've used a very soft cake, so it was kind of getting a bit lopsided. So anyway, done my one layer of ganache. I'm just gonna let it harden before I fill in the gaps and properly ganache my cake.
Okay, so I have this cutter. This is just a five, I think it's just called a five petal rose cutter. So I've just got my red here and I've added some tylo powder. We don't need all of it. I'm just going to roll it out thinly. Okay, I can cut two out. Okay, so I'm just gonna lift up my Okay, so gently lifted it up, that's fine. This is my veiner. So one side is like that and the other side is just flat. So this flat side, I'm just gonna put a bit of, I've got just a bit of corn flour, corn starch, just to sort of, you just don't want it to stick on this side. And then make sure you sort of, I'm just wiping it on my pants. You just don't want it to, you don't want to get the white on the on that side of the flour. So then you just put the top on, give it a bit of a squeeze, and then when you take it off, you can see that your flour's got nice veins in it. And because you put the cornstarch, it should just easily come off. Okay, see, it ripped a bit at the end. Bugger, that's annoying. But I'm gonna still use it anyway. And then I've got this foam block. I'm just going to get, what tool I think it's called a boning tool. Anyway, it's that tool. And then just, I'm gonna gently just thin out the edges, just very gently. So annoying, I ripped a little bit off. So yeah, you need to make sure you put the cornstarch in over the whole thing. And then I've got this here. So it's just a foam block. It's kind of like, you know, when you go to the fruit and veggie shop and you see the apples or the berries in there, and you could get some of those as well. I think I just picked that up from a cake decorating shop. So what I'm gonna do is, because I'm making quite a few flowers, I'm just basically gonna put it. If you have a look here, see, it can just sit in there, which is quite handy. And if you need to, you know, ruffle things up a bit, you kind of can. So I'm just gonna leave that there like that. And then what we're gonna do is, with a bit of my yellow, I've got this. So I got this. This is from First Impressions. They make silicone molds. They are the best quality. Honestly, I would just use the money and buy First Impressions instead of any other mold because they're great. I'm just going to use my yellow and make a little, see how big I want. I think I'm going to use this really big one in the center. So it's really easy to use. You just get your fondant and put it in the middle. If your hand's a little bit like that, if your hand is a little bit sweaty but wet, you can use a bit of baking paper. So here you go, like that, and then you can just push it out. It's got a bit of, there you go, a bit of dust. You can see it just has a beautiful print on it. So that's cool. So I'm just going to stick that down. I'm going to keep making flowers. Next up, I've got some green. This is pre-colored green that I bought because I just for another cake. So that's it there. Satin ice green vanilla flavor. Not that anyone hates this, but anyway, I've just added some tallow powder. I have these cutters that I'm just gonna roll out and make some leaves. Okay, I'm just going to make the big leaf that is going to have the happy birthday on it. So I've just added tallow and I'm just going to roll it out. Right, I'm actually going to cut out the name Fiona with, these are click sticks. I've rolled out yellow fondant, which I've mixed with tallow. And then you got to let it sit for a bit so you can get it out. Just one more try. Okie dokie, so I'm just gonna cut these out and let them dry. Okay, when putting the letters, I find the easiest way to do it is to put your middle letter. So Fiona is five letters, so the O is the middle letter, just so it's always on it. The amount of times I've put on names and they've just been, you know, too much, they haven't been centered properly. So this is the way I do it now. Get the O, put it in the middle. Cool, happy with that. Okay, this is how I'm getting it to dry. I figure because it's going to be a circular cake, so I'll just sort of get it to dry a bit like that, and that should be fine. Okay, I'm just going to add some tallow to some leftover terracotta fondant so I can make the rim and it's nice and hard. Okay, I'm just putting a bit of water just around the rim, just so I can attach. Sorry about that light in the way. Looking at all my flowers here, I'm thinking maybe my pink and my red is going to be too similar in colour to my terracotta, which is really annoying. So anyway, I'm going to grab some glaze and put it on these flowers, and I think I might have to do a few more flowers. Okay, so I've got that chocolate ripple biscuits that I've just whizzed up in my Thermomix, so just crunch up some biscuits, and that's going to be my dirt. I'm just going to put it on top of my cake here, put a bit of water, and then just dump it on so it looks like dirt. Okay, so can you see there? How easy was that? Okay, so I'm going to roll out some more lighter pink flowers, and then I'm just going to set them all on top. Okay, so I've got my flowers here. I've just made these extra colors, put some glaze on them, and I've started up here just trying to work out how I'm going to decorate this. So I'll show you what it looks like once it's all finished. You can see down here, I've stuffed up around the side, cut that a bit too early. Anyway, I'll have to find something to put there.